Merry Christmas, and welcome to the Unitarian Universalist Society of Amherst. I'm the Reverend Rachel Hayes, and it is my honor to serve as the minister of the Unitarian Universalist Society of Amherst. We are one people of many beliefs, origins, sexualities, and genders. We are one people. In this time together, we celebrate Christmas. We tell the story of how Christmas began. We come to know its characters. A young woman about to give birth to her first child. Her partner ready to receive this miracle. A donkey carrying a special burden. Shepherds and sheep doing the ordinary work of waiting out the night. Wise people waiting for a sign, an angel full of good news, and a baby about to enter the world as babies have always entered the world. In this time together, we sing Christmas carols, old songs, some of them hundreds of years old, that tell the story of Christmas. They might not be words we use very often, with words like thee and savior and Lord, but part of the mystery is in joining hands with people across time, telling this story together over the generations. Now, with open minds and open hearts, we enter the mystery of Christmas. Come, let us worship.
Spirits by your presence here. A star lit the way to the place where the baby Jesus was born. We light our chalice now as a star to guide us. May it burn brightly and show us the way.
Almost 5 years ago, I got to take an amazing trip to El Salvador. El Salvador is the smallest country in Central America, on the Pacific Ocean side, by Guatemala and Honduras. I went in early January, and there were still lots of Christmas decorations everywhere. I went into a church, and there was a life-size nativity scene with Mary, Joseph, and baby Jesus. They had brown skin and were dressed like Lenca people, who are native to that part of the world and were there before Europeans. They were beautiful. The next day, I bought this nativity set. Here's one of the figures. It's painted in a popular folk art style from El Salvador. And when I look at it, it reminds me how powerful it is to see the characters in the Christmas story as people we recognize. First, we have Mary. Mary is a young woman. She's about to have her first baby. Next is Joseph. Joseph is engaged to Mary. This is how the story of Christmas goes. In those days, Caesar Augustus declared that everyone throughout the empire should be enrolled in the tax lists. Everyone went to their own cities to be enrolled. Since Joseph belonged to David's house and family line, he went up from the city of Nazareth in Galilee to David's city, called Bethlehem, in Judea. He went to be enrolled together with Mary, who was promised to him in marriage and who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn child, a son, wrapped him snugly and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the guest room. The story says that everyone had to go back to their hometown to be counted. So Mary and Joseph had to go to Bethlehem. But they didn't have cars 2,000 years ago. They had to walk everywhere, and Mary was very pregnant. So she couldn't walk far. It's said that Mary rode a donkey to Bethlehem. Mary and Joseph found a place for the baby to be born, but it wasn't in a room or a bed. It was among the animals, like this ox. And the baby was born. Mary and Joseph named him Jesus. Jesus grew up to be a teacher who helped people find a better way to live. His message was so revolutionary that some people said he was the Son of God. Some people even said he was God. And there are many different beliefs about Jesus. But for this part of the story, Jesus is a newborn baby. Mary and Joseph wrapped him up in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger. Do you know what a manger is? It's a food trough where you would put hay for animals to eat. The next figures in the set are sheep. The sheep are out in the field with their shepherds. But my nativity set doesn't have shepherds, and I think they're pretty important. So these people will be our shepherds. So the shepherds are out in the fields with their sheep at night, and an angel appears to the shepherds, which is scary to see an angel come from nowhere. This is how the shepherd's story goes. Nearby, shepherds were living in the fields, guarding their sheep at night. The Lord's angel stood before them, and the Lord's glory shone around them, and they were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Look, I bring good news to you. Wonderful, joyous news for all people. Your Savior is born today in David's city. He is Christ the Lord. This is a sign for you. You will find a newborn baby wrapped snugly and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great assembly of the heavenly forces was with the angel, praising God. They said, "Glory to God in heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors." When the angels returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go right now to Bethlehem and see what's happened. Let's confirm what the Lord has revealed to us." They went quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw this, they reported what they had been told about this child. Everyone who heard it was amazed at what the shepherds told them. Mary committed these things to memory and considered them carefully. The shepherds returned home, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. Everything happened just as they had been told.
The first Noel, the angel did say,
Some people say that they were kings or astrologers, people who try to understand the world by looking at the stars. They're not in the story for very long, but they're known as wise men or wise people. These wise people had been watching the sky and saw the star that announced Jesus' birth. They followed the star to find Jesus and Mary and Joseph, and they brought presents. This is how the wise people's part of the story goes. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in the territory of Judea during the rule of King Herod, Magi came from the east to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We've seen his star in the east, and we've come to honor him." When King Herod heard this, he was troubled, and everyone in Jerusalem was troubled with him. He gathered all the chief priests and the legal experts and asked them where the Christ was to be born. They said, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this is what the prophet wrote. You, Bethlehem, land of Judah, by no means are you least among the rulers of Judah, because from you will come one who governs, who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called for the Magi and found out from them the time when the star had first appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search carefully for the child. When you found him, report to me so that I too may go and honor him." When they heard the king, they went, and look, the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stood over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were filled with joy. They entered the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother. Falling to their knees, they honored him. Then they opened their treasure chests and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, because they were warned in a dream not to return to Herod. They went back to their own country by another route. The presents that the wise people brought were gold and frankincense and myrrh. You know what gold is, but what do you know about frankincense and myrrh? Frankincense and myrrh are smelly. They're made from the sap of plants, cooked in a way to make incense or perfume. What you really need to know is that they are expensive, just like gold. These are fancy presents.
Wherever
Of course, there are other characters in the Christmas story, but these are the ones in my nativity set, plus the shepherds I borrowed. The next time you look at a nativity set, maybe think of which character inspires you or has something to teach you. Please join me in meditation and prayer. Spirit of Christmas, we open our hearts to this moment now. For so many of us, this has been a hard year, a year of loss, loneliness, and disappointment. Let us not ignore the sorrows that arrived alongside joys, or the joys that arrived alongside sorrows. We open our hearts to Christmas, to wild, disruptive, unpredictable love. Love that shows up like a child needing infinite care and gentle attention. May Christmas enter our hearts as we tell the stories and sing the songs. Christmas, transform us. Help us to grow in love and have faith that we too are loved. May we become fierce protectors of the holy beings all around us until everyone has a warm place to sleep and enough food to eat, until all people are free and know they are loved. May everyone looking for hope see it as clear as a star in the sky. May everyone listening for good news hear it as loud as angels. May everyone reaching out for love hold it in their arms, solid as a baby. May Christmas find us all. Amen. And blessed be.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. On your knees, oh, hey.
There's another character who sometimes gets a part in a Christmas pageant, though not usually in a nativity scene. I'm talking about the innkeeper, the person who sees that Mary and Joseph need something, a place to stay. And in the versions of the story I like best, even though the innkeeper doesn't have a room or bed left to offer, they give Mary and Joseph a place to stay, and Jesus a place to be born. This congregation has been the innkeeper to many people. Through the minister's discretionary fund, you have provided necessary help to people in our community who needed it. Sometimes it is help with a bill or some money to hold somebody over until more money comes in. Sometimes it's the last little bit that makes a whole new life possible. You do this. Our Christmas offering benefits the minister's discretionary fund. Please give generously so that we can continue to be the innkeeper all year long. These words come from The Mood of Christmas by Howard Thurman. I will light candles this Christmas. Candles of joy despite all the sadness. Candles of hope where despair keeps watch. Candles of courage for fears ever present. Candles of peace for tempest-tossed days. Candles of grace to ease heavy burdens. Candles of love to inspire all my living. Candles that will burn all year long. I invite you to turn down the lights and light a candle as we sing Silent Night.
Thank you.
I extinguish the light of our chalice because we now hold that light in our hands. Breathe in, breathe out. This is Christmas. And now we extinguish our candles too because we hold the lights of them in our hearts.
Go forth and carry the light of Christmas in your heart. Let it light your way. Pass it to everyone you meet. Peace on earth and goodwill to all people everywhere. Merry Christmas.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive. Let every heart prepare him room.
And heaven and nature sing.
And heaven and nature sing.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the earth, the Savior reigns. Let all their songs employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills and plains,
repeat the sounding
repeat
joy,
the sounding
repeat
joy,
the sounding
repeat
joy,
the sounding
repeat,
joy,
repeat, repeat the sounding joy.
He rules the world with truth and grace, and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness
and wonders of his love.
Of his
and
love.
Wonders of